Hello everyone, today we start with the unit number 2, that is digital TV and display devices. Okay, so let us discuss first topic, that is introduction to digital TV. Okay, so why digital TV? Advances made in the field of microelectronics have brought the world virtually on a chip. Due to VLSI technology, digital electronics has made an impact on almost all areas in electronics and digital technology. It has also made its impact on TV system because almost all the telecommunication system are using this technology. Now, in the existing TV system, the input signal of the camera and the output signal of the picture tube are analog signal. If the digital technique is used for TV system, the composite video signal must be digitized. Okay? That is, binary zeros and one must be used. Okay? Digitization of the composite video signal involves high speed A to D converter and very high bit rate of the transmission. So that's why we use or we replace all the analog system into the digital TV system. Okay, so let us discuss first one, classification of the television transmitter, which is divided into two parts, analog TV transmission and the digital TV transmission. Okay. So this analog TV transmission, which is of three types, PAL, NTSC, CCAM, we already discussed all these terms. Okay, so now few countries have already stopped and many countries have announced to stop analog TV transmission. Okay, so there are three types of this analog transmission system: terrestrial broadcast, satellite broadcast and the cable broadcast. Okay, so now next type, digital TV transmission, which is divided into two: composite encoded TV transmission, component encoded DTV transmission. Okay, so this composite encoded DTV transmission is of three types: terrestrial broadcast, satellite broadcast and the cable broadcast. Okay, so this component encoded DTV transmission, which is of three, use two technology: MAC technology and the advanced DTV technology. Okay, so this MAC technology use this three broadcasting system: terrestrial broadcast, satellite broadcast and the cable broadcast. Same thing here, in case of the advanced DTV technology, there are three types: terrestrial broadcast, satellite broadcast and the cable broadcast. Okay, so which is again of three types: ATSC, DVB and ISDP. Okay, so let us discuss this, all these three types. Okay, so these are the three television standards: ATSC, which is used in USA and South Korea, ISDP, which is used in Japan and Brazil, DVB is used in Europe, Asia, Africa, Australia and New Zealand. Okay, so let us discuss about the first type, that is advanced television system committee. The modulation used in ATSC is 8 VSB, that is in some way similar to analog NTSC based on a single carrier. This modulation technique provides 19.39 Mbps data payload in a 6 MHz TV channel. It is possible to transmit one HDTV program or up to 4 standard definition program in a single 6 MHz channel. The transport stream used in MPEG-2 and audio coding is Dolby Digital AC-3 format, providing theater-like quality audio. Various auxiliary data casting services are also possible. Now let us discuss second type, that is digital video broadcasting terrestrial. It uses coded orthogonal frequency division multiplexing modulation and supports hierarchical transmission that provides data payload up to 19 Mbps speed. developed by Digital Video Broadcasting Project Group, uses similar technology to DRB. It is possible to transmit one HDTV program or up to four standard definition program in 6, 7 or 8 megahertz channel. The used transport streams are MPEG 2 and MPEG 4 AVS. DVB can also provide mobile handheld services, data casting and interactive services. Now, third type, integrated services, digital broadcasting. It uses COFDM modulation with almost all the same techniques as DVB. In ISDB, it is possible to transmit one HDTV program or up to four standard definition program plus one SIG program in a 6 MHz TV channel. The transport stream uses for HD and SD program is MPEG 2, while for SIG 1, MPEG 4 AVS is used. It can also provide data casting and interactive services. It uses time interleaving technique, providing more improvement in reception performance, especially under noisy mobile and indoor reception conditions. DVB and ISDB are similar in some way because they use same multiple carrier modulation technique. This allows the two standards to provide mobile broadcasting services and deploy single frequency networks in same geographical areas. Digital terrestrial multimedia broadcasting adopts time division synchronous OFDM technology with pseudo random signal frame to serve as a guard interval of the OFDM block and the training symbol. DMB is a digital radio transmission technology developed for sending multimedia such as TV, radio and data casting to mobile devices such as mobile phones, laptop and GPS navigation systems. Okay, so let us discuss advantages of digital transmission. Noise is less and hence quality is high. Digital systems are reliable as error detecting and correcting codes are possible. Same distance is transmitted at lower power. More channels and programs can be accommodated in the given spectrum compared with analog transmission. That is, in digital TV transmission, four more program can be broadcast than the analog TV. As distortion is less during transmission, copy of the first transmission is same as the 100th copy. Duplication is possible with the digital signal. Errors such as double image, reflection, distortion and so on are not possible. Digital circuits are cheaper. Digital circuits are suitable for VLSI technology. In digital form, the signal can be stored, displayed and manipulated. So now, after that, let us discuss about the digital TV broadcasting system. Figure shows the digital TV broadcasting system. The audio and video signal from studio are in MPEG 2 coded multiplex, which are modulated using quadrature amplitude modulation or quadrature phase shift keying and microwave converter. The QAM or QPSK modulated carrier is converted to microwave frequency using microwave converter and transmitted to microwave link or satellite link as shown in the figure. okay, let us discuss digital transmitter. The signal at the transmitting station is converted back into radio frequency by microwave receiving converter demodulated for analog or digital transmission. For digital transmission, either OFDM or 8VSD is modulated and transmitted through transmitting antenna. The signal is then received at the receiving end and demodulated using set-top box. The signal at the set-top box is either RF output, which is modulated using amplitude modulation and frequency modulation for video and audio respectively at the TV receiver. The output of set-top box is detected as audio-video, which is directly given to the speaker and display respectively. In digital transmission, the pulse code modulation is used for converting the analog composite video into binary form. Analog signal suffers degradation in transmission path to noise, crosstalk, linear and nonlinear distortion in the circuit. In pulse code modulation system, binary code is transmitted for corresponding modulating voltage. Recovering of the transmitted information does not depend on the height, width or energy content of the pulse, but only on their presence or absence. The block diagram for the conversion of the composite video signal to digital form is shown in the figure. The process involves the basic operation, that is sampling, quantization and the encoding. Let us discuss first one, sampling. The composite video signal is sampled at an Nyquist rate, that is the sampling frequency is at least equal to or greater than 2 times the highest modulating frequency, that is fs is greater than or equal to the 2 fm, where fs is the sampling frequency and fm is the modulating frequency. The sampling theorem states that if the sampling rate in any pulse code modulation system exceeds twice the maximum signal frequency, the original signal can be reconstructed at the receiver with the minimum distortion. In sampling requirements of digital TV signal, it is necessary to consider the scanning process, which has already a sampled image in vertical, horizontal and time dimension. Sampling at the minimum rate result in a three-dimensional sampling grid pattern. The rectangular scanning grid can take different patterns as shown in the figure. The field aligned grid consists of sampling grid that has rectangular projection both in the spatial and horizontal temporal direction. The field offset grid is more efficient in spectral density. Due to half sampling period, offset for the interstellar field. The board grid, the checkerboard grid formed by offsetting the sampling period offset for interstellar field. The double checkerboard grid is obtained by half sampling period offset at every two lengths for the beta spectral properties. So next point is regarding the quantization. In quantization process, the total range of the modulating signal is divided into number of small subranges. The number will depends on the nature of the modulating signal and will be formed as few as 8 to as many as 128 levels. A number which is integer of power of 2 is usually chosen because generating binary codes. A new signal is generated by producing each sample voltage level corresponding to the midpoint level of the subrange in which sample falls. For example, consider that the composite video signal has a range of 0 to 4 volt. Let it be divided into 1 volt subrange. Consider the signal was sampled when the voltage level was 2.8 volt. The quantizer would give a voltage of 2.5 volt corresponding to the midpoint of the third range. The result is a step waveform which follow the contour of the original modulating signal with each step synchronized to the sampling period. The process of quantization is shown in the figure. The quantized staircase waveform is an approximation to the original waveform. The difference between the two waveforms is called quantization noise. The quantization noise is reduced by taking more number of levels. For digital TV, satisfactory picture quality is possible with the quantization of 8 bit per sample. Okay. Next one is the encoding process. The encoding process generates a binary code number corresponding to the quantization level number to be transmitted for each sampling interval. Binary coding is the binary number corresponding to the decimal number of the level transmitted. This binary number contains a train of 1 and 0 pulse with a total of log of n pulse in each number, where n is the number of levels in full range. The binary code are usually accompanied by purity bits for error detection, scrambling, etc. An error in a code can be corrected using the automatic repeat request or forward error correction technique. Block coding and convolution codes are used in a digital TV system. Next one is the digital modulation. The digital modulation used are QPSK modulation for satellite communication, QAM for cable, coded orthogonal frequency division multiplexing for terrestrial transmission in Europe, and 8VSB in United States. Next one, we will discuss regarding the transmission of digital signal. Digital TV signals are transmitted via copper cable, fiber optic cable, digital microwave radio or satellite relay link. Twisted pair cable can be delivered up to 10 Mbps, which is equal to 1 km, while RF coaxial cable can be transmitted without repeaters up to gigabits per second over a range of 1 km. Limited factors for the cable transmission are attenuation, crosstalk, echoes, symbol interference, and thermal and impulse noise. Fiber optic cables can be transmitted to 2 to 100 Mbps more than a span reach of 10 of kilometers. Using laser light emitted display for transmitter and avalanche photo detector can be provided larger distance than the LED and pin diode combination. In bit parallel transmission for the 8 bit digital word or 10 bit corresponding in 256 levels or 1024 levels are used in PCM. The luminance is at the 13.5 MHz and chrominance difference signal is at the 6.75 MHz. The multiplex bit rate for each of the conducting pair is 27 Mbps. An additional pair carries the 27 MHz clock along with the data consisting of non-return to zero binary output. Gamma corrected RGB signal is converted into luminance component Y and two scale prominence component PB and PR. As human eyes is more sensitive to change in brightness than changes in hue, the Y signal is carried by the system at the higher bandwidth, that is 5.5 MHz. The luminance and chrominance signal are low pass filter to eliminate higher video frequency that might cause aliasing in the sampling process. The filter luminance signal is sampled at a rate of 13.5 MHz in an analog to digital converter to produce a 10-bit data stream at 13.5 Mbps. The two chrominance channels are filtered and then sampled at 6.75 MHz in analog to digital converter to produce two data stream at 6.75 Mbps. The three video channels are multiplexed to a single 10-bit parallel data stream at 27 Mbps. This digitization is shown in the figure. A coprocessor is used for adding formatted digital audio and other auxiliary data. An error detection is applied by a cyclic redundancy check. Checksum for the data and added to the parallel data stream. The 27 Mbps 10-bit parallel data are then loaded into shift register where they are scrambled and the parallel data are serialized at a data rate of 270 Mbps. The scrambling is done for efficient transmission. These signals are carried by a standard video cable up to about 300 meter with approximate 100% data integrity. At the receiver, the 270 Mbps data signal is recovered by the unscrambling the data using algorithm opposite to the encoder scrambling algorithm. The output is a 10-bit data stream at the 27 Mbps. The CRC checksum is extracted by the receiver and compared to the new checksum produced from the received data and an error is reported. And the appropriate flag is added to the data stream. A coprocessor extract any audio or other auxiliary data. This process of extraction at the receiver is shown in the figure. The 10-bit data is then demultiplexed into digital luminance and prominence data stream and converted into the analog by three digital to analog converter filter to reconstruct the discrete data levels back to the analog waveform. The matrix back to the original RGB for display. The conversion of digital 10-bit to analog form is shown in the figure. Although many current implementation of ITU-RBT 601 uses the 10-bit sampling. ITU square BT.601 permits either 8-bit sample or 10-bit sample corresponding to the range of 1024 levels. Specified 8-bit word value may be directly converted into 10-bit value, and 10-bit value may be rounded to 8-bit values for interoperability. The digital values of code difference CB and CR in the range of 040-3C0 corresponding to the analog signal around plus minus 350 millivolt. So this is regarding digital transmission of the digital signal using the transmitter and the receiver. Let us discuss next point, that is parameters for digital TV transmission. These are the standard parameters used for digital coding of the television signal for 525 line system as well as in those using the 625 line system. The table describes the parameters for both 525 line system and 625 line system. These standards are recommended by ITU-RBT.601-5. This recommendation specifies a method for digitally coding video signal. It includes a 13.5 MHz sampling rate for both 4:3 aspect ratio and 16:9 aspect ratio. An alternative 18 MHz sampling rate for those 16:9 system, which requires proportionally higher horizontal resolution, is specified. The standards are based on the use of one luminous and two color difference signals. Okay, so let us discuss parameter one by one using both system, that is 525 line 60 field system as well as for 625 lines 50 field system. Okay, so let us discuss first parameter, that is line frequency. For the 525 line, it is 15,750 hertz, and in case of this 625 line, it is 15,625 hertz. Now active lines for 525 line, it is 485, and in case of 625 line 50 field system, it is 575. Frame rate for the 60 field system, it is 30 hertz, and it is 25 for 625 lines 50 field system. Bandwidth, this is important parameter regarding this digital TV transmission. It is 4.5 MHz for 525 line system, and it is 5.5 MHz for 625 line 50 field system. Now next point, next parameter regarding this transmission, that is sampling frequency, which is of two types, luminous signal and each color difference signal. Okay, for the luminous signal, it is 13.5 MHz for 525 line system, and same thing for the 625 line also. Now next sub point, that is each color difference signal, it is 6.75 MHz for 525 line system, and same thing for the 625 line system. Next point, next parameter, number of samples per total lines, again which is of two types, luminous signal and each color different signal. For the luminous signal it is 858 for 525 line system and it is 864 for 625 line system. Now for the each color different signal it is 429 for 525 line system and it is 432 for 625 line system. Okay. Next important method, that is the coding. In case of the 525 line system, uniformly quantize PCM 8 bit per sample or 10 bits per sample for the luminous signal and each different signal is used. Now same thing for the 625 line also, that is uniformly quantize PCM 8 bits per sample or 10 bits per sample for the luminous signal and each color different signal is used. Okay. So this is the important parameters regarding the digital DV transmission.